With me, Terry Kay. I want to try and do a quick one. This is a Budweiser, and now this is Budvar. It's not the American Budweiser, this is the Czech Budweiser, and there's a lot of kind of, I don't want to get too much into it, but there's a lot of kind of legal wranglings. There have been legal wranglings for forever, for ages. It's cost them both money, it's cost them both fortunes, but the ones that are really suffering, these so-called Budvar, I call them Budweiser, and I call the others Amvar, but that's just me, you know. As far as I'm concerned, these are, look, argue with me if you will, but as far as I'm concerned, these are more entitled to the name Budweiser. Whatever. They're not particularly a brilliant beer, you know. They're better than the American Budweiser or the Amvar. But in America, it has to be sold as Budvar. I'm going to do a couple of beers here. Right? One, I kind of think he's like, as if they ain't got enough trouble as it is, you know, Budweiser or Budvar, as it is. You've got ones that, which in different countries will be Budvar, right? Take it as that. This one in our country is Budweiser. It's Vlativar. There you go, look at that. Look. They're a little bit similar. A little bit similar, so. Look, it's enough kind of, you know, when you go, well, there's enough kind of, what do you call it, enough difference to get away with, but that's similar. That ain't by accident, I'm sure it ain't. If it was by accident, you'd go, oh, do you know what, we better change that because that looks a little bit like so-and-so's. They've got a little kind of like lions and crap on us there and all that business behind it. And funny enough, these have got little lions and stuff. I don't know if you can see that behind it. Where are we? No, you can't see it in this light. Wait a minute. There we go. Down near like a watermark, you can see that behind it. Yeah. So, yeah. But there you go. Czech imported lager. Czech Pilsner lager. I'm going to be doing them together, and I'm going to be doing them separate. But let's do them separate. Let's do them together first. Shall I do them together first or separate? Do them together first. Right. That one, me umpty dumpty, I'm going to have the Budvar, the original item. And I'm going to have my really lovely Beer by the River one. I'm going to have the what is that? Vratislav, whatever it is. Right, so smash them open. Let's do a side by side. Yeah, I think kind of, whoa. Quite active. It's already completely steamed in. Now, green bottle. Not always a good idea for hoppy beers and what have you. But that said, these guys know what they're doing. They've been at it a long time. A lot longer than us reviewers have. And me personally, I've never had a skunky I've had very few skunky beers, but I think one of the skunky beers I had was this chap. I may not be remembering that correctly, but I'm sure it was that chap. So anyway, I poured him out. Plain. That one was, you know, foily. So let's pour this out. This one hasn't exploded. Right, so let's see what the difference are. What the difference is, I should say. Or what the difference is. Oh. Same colour bottle, same colour everything. Same sort of font, almost exactly. So this, where are we? This was the Vlatistar, whatever it is. Look, exactly the same. Aroma. Gentle, and everything else. Slightly more lemony in the Budvar one. Slightly, just a touch more lemony. But bread notes and things like that, so all that going on. Let's try that, the Vlatislav, whatever it is. Let's try that. Right. Boring. Let's have a taste. It does taste boring. It's kind of like white bread, white music, white pro. It's just wow. It's kind of 50 shades of white, that sort of thing. White. White flour, white bread, white music, white whatever, white everything. White noise. Let's taste this one. Right, that's uninspirational as well. But you are getting a little bit more, right, a tiny bit more crust on your bread. As if the other ones just cut everything. Anything that might have a bit of flavour, like the crust on the bread, cut that off and just leave you with a bit of bread. Bread and water. This one's got the crust on the bread. It's got little hints of lemon. Little hints of grapefruit zest. Back to that one, the Vratislav. There's a very generic bitterness there, a very generic hop, but there's something quite delicious amongst all the crap in there. That's very strange, very worrying as well, because I think they could do so much better. Oh, they could do so much better because there's a lot of crap, a lot of really crap flavours, a lot of McLager flavours. So it's like generic hops, generic malts, generic, ugh, ugh, ugh. And then there's something buttery, vanilla-like almost, and quite smooth and lovely. That is so weird. Those, with a tiny bit more effort, could be really good. Those there, they're okay, you know, a million times better than their counterparts, the Anvar, American Budweiser, you know, it's called it the name that yous call it, but the Indoctrination Corporation Anvar. Personally, well, I prefer that, but it's a long way off of being a great beer. And I think that if it's eaten into, if kind of arguing with the so-called Budweiser, I think if arguing with them is costing so much, what is the name? You know, what is a rose by any other name? A rose by any other name would still smell as sweet. If you completely forgot spending your money into fighting a massive corporation for the rights to a name, if you just completely forgot that and went, do you know what, okay, call us Anvar, call us Budvar, whatever. Call us Budvar, you know, in America they're licensed as Budvar only, you know, not Budweiser. Even though they've got more entitlements than name, you know, they're fighting a losing battle with a big corporation. And what's happening is the beers are suffering because they're fighting a losing battle. If they put all that money into the beers they produce, the beers would be the Westie 12s. They would be massively brilliant beers. They'd be fantastic beers, and they would sing their own praises. And you know, you could call them whatever you liked. You can call them Spunknik or something or whatever. And they would be brilliant. At the moment, they're suffering. So, whatever one you want to pick, you know, they're all much or much. This one, they're a bit better. They've got a bit of flavour still. And they're certainly better than Budweiser, America, Anvar or whatever. Anvar. They're a million times better than that. So these are a million times better than American Budweiser. A million times better. But and these here are still 100 times better than American Budweiser. And if you're trying to tell me that ain't a copy, I don't know who you are. Because there's a copy going on there. But that there's still better, a lot better than American Budweiser. And they're not bad, you know, they're cheap enough and everything. But guys, give the fight up. It's one of them fights you're just gonna fight, you know, unless you put a bomb under their thing and blow it up completely. Even then they'll build it again the next day. The fight's not worth fighting, you know, it's a name, and a rose by any other name, whatever, call it Westie 12, fight with him, you know, but call it whatever you like, call it something else, and produce a good beer, fuck 'em, you know, so, sorry, but, I do have to say it, but, you know, I really think that Budweiser, the proper Budweiser, these guys, I think they could produce a beer so much better than that. So much better than that. I don't think they could. But they're suffering under the weight of so much legal crap. Maybe that's working in their I don't know, maybe that's working for them as well and giving them a lot of publicity. I don't know. Maybe that is. Maybe if they was just called Budvar all around the world and everything and that was it, maybe all the publicity would be lost and they'd be like, But I really think if they produced the beer with the money they've got instead of wasting it, if they produced a beer that was great, they could really do it, because that's almost there. But it's a long way off. Anyway. Cheerio. Bottoms up. Chin chin. See you next one. Don't be late. For the band to play, with the band.